Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining to the webinar in which we will talk about how to achieve a fast and automatic human semen analysis. There is a growing demand on requesting a lot of semen analysis, both in IVF clinics, but also in general hospitals. And this is a big challenge for all these technicians and specialists that need to handle, need to manage all this high quantity of samples in the laboratory. This is why we have developed a fully automatic system, the SCA SCOPE, that not only allows to optimize the time invested for doing its analysis, but also allows to make easy to facilitate the connection, the transmission of information between the system and the main laboratory informatics system. This SCA SCOPE allows to perform the standard analysis recommended by the WHO, that could be the sperm concentration or sperm motility. But also it allows to perform a sperm functional test, that could be the ability of sperms to penetrate through the cervical mucus or the sensitivity of these cells to hyperactivate when are stimulated, when are post-treated. Also, on the same analysis, the system is able to take into account the number of round cells that are present in the ejaculate, because that is not only interesting to account for the number of sperm cells, but also it's important to count for these round cells or for these leukocytes that could be linked to a possible infection in the patient. Also, the system is able to recognize automatically the presence of agglutinations, is able to measure automatically the pH of the sample, and allows the analysis of fresh samples, but also post-treated samples and thawed samples. The same time that is performing this basic analysis also allows to perform a detailed analysis of the morphological parameters, not only paying attention to the morphology of these sperm cells, but also on the morphometry and on the this deformity index that the WHO recommends to calculate. That could be the teratosperm index, multiple abnormality indexes, or deformity index. At the same time that it's important to calculate all these parameters, it's important to assess for the sperm vitality, especially when there is a poor motility. We have to think that IVF clinics need to rescue as much cells as possible. So when there is a poor motility, it's important to evaluate from these immotile cells how many are alive or how many are dead. Okay? And on the same way that we are evaluating the integrity of the membranes with the vitality test, also we can test for the presence of DNA breakages for DNA fragmentation on these sperm cells. That will be very critical for any reproductive treatment. Okay? Finally, it is also important to assess for the presence of peroxidase cells. When there are more than 1 million round cells per milliliter, WHO recommends to do the peroxidase test in order to detect prematurely a possible infection in the patient. So this system automatically helps the technician to do on a very fast way this type of test. So every time that we are opening the system, it is automatically calibrated. Okay, so it's not necessary to spend some time in doing any maintenance or any type of test that allow the calibration of the system. It is automatically calibrated. Okay, once you open the system, you can log in according different profiles. You can log in as an administrator, as an analyst, or as a viewer. Okay, or just to create a specific profile for your team. Just important to know that only the administrator is the person that is able to have access to the fully configuration of the system, and is the person that can modify configurations and settings for the analysis. Okay, these profiles are linked or can be linked to a specific password. Okay, in order to allow our privacy. We will log in. Okay. So a very important point is just to take into account that before starting the day, it's important to do some internal quality controls in order to verify that configurations of the system has not been modified and that everything is running perfectly. Okay? This system allows to perform two types of internal quality controls. First, it allows to analyze some stored images, stored videos, that allows to control that the different parameters are optimally detected, are optimally calculated. So therefore the system is running perfectly. But also it's possible to do another type of internal quality control in vivo by using the QC bits or similar solutions, in which we have, like you can see here, okay, there are two types of solutions in which there are some latex bits floating there, and we know the exact concentration for that bits on each solution. So we can just compare the concentration calculated by the system, but this that we expect to found on each solution. Hence, we can just easily verify that the system accuracy is okay, okay, that the system is calculating properly. So once we have performed these internal quality controls, we can just start with our routine. Okay, we will start with the motility and concentration test because the motility is a spam parameter that is very sensitive to the passage of time. Okay, so this should be assessed as soon as possible. We will start selecting on motility. Okay, and the first thing to do is just introduce a patient. Okay, there are some laboratories in which it is possible to connect that system to the main laboratory informatics system. In that cases, each system will receive a list of the patients of the samples to do each day. And in that cases, technicians only just need to click on each patient and start the analysis. If not, it is also possible to connect the system to a barcode reader and just read its sample and automatically upload this information to the system or just introduce the information of the patient manually. Okay. So here I will introduce this new patient. And once the patient information is introduced, the system will allow you to incorporate all this information concerning the macroscopic information of the sample, which is the appearance, which is the volume, which is the viscosity, the liquefaction is complete, is not complete, all this macroscopic information that could be useful for doing a good interpretation of the results should be uploaded here as soon as possible. Okay? In the case of the volume, it is possible to connect the system to a scale and just put the sample there and transfer the information from the scale to the system automatically. If not, you can just write it manually. Once we have filled all this macroscopic information, we can just proceed to the sample preparation. In that case, we can use two types of counting chambers. If we are following the WHO guidelines, we will use a type of counting chambers that contains two chambers with a depth of 10 microns and that there is a pH strip, okay, in one corner in order to evaluate the pH too. This is important for doing replicates, okay? So in these accredited laboratories, we recommend just to use this type of counting chambers. If not, there is also the possibility to use another type of counting chambers that allowed to load the samples for 6 different patients, okay? In that case, you will optimize the use of these slides. But it is not possible to do automatically replicates or measuring automatically the pH. So here I have one example of these slides that we will load it with our sample. Okay, we will just take a pipette, a tip, okay, and we will load the chamber, Okay, first one chamber, then the second chamber, okay, and finally the pH. We put the pH, okay, and once it's loaded, we will introduce it in the system. And automatically will run the analysis. The system will capture 500 sperms on each chamber and automatically will calculate the average between both chambers. Then we'll move to the pH strip and calculate the pH strip. Okay? In our moment, we can control what the system is doing. Since here, you will see a small preview of the fields that the system is capturing. Okay, and control that everything is running properly. Okay, also it's important to control the homogeneity of the sample. Okay, just the system will capture different fields on one chamber, different fields on other chamber. And it's important to control that the sample that you are analyzing is representative from the whole ejaculate. So we will just compare these different concentration, these different sperm parameters that we will found on each capture, okay? Here you can see that just in few seconds, the analysis is finished. There are the main results displayed in that screen, but also there is the possibility to open the session, open the fields, and just check the analysis, okay? And check that everything is okay. Also, it's possible that to introduce some manual modification. So this is not a closed system. You can just introduce some changes, okay? But before paying attention to the results, it is important to evaluate the homogeneity of that sample. So here there is the comparison option in which the system automatically detects if there is a variation higher than the 20% between fields. If this variation is higher than the 20%, we'll display these fields in red. And therefore, you should, we recommend to eliminate it, to delete it from the analysis in order to get fully homogeneous results, okay? There is also the possibility to customize the system for doing automatically the deleting of the samples that are heterogeneous. So these fields that are out of the average value will be automatically deleted from the analysis. Okay? Once we have checked that everything is homogeneous, that everything is representative from the whole ejaculate, we can just pay attention to the main results. Here it will be displayed the total concentration, the different types of sperm motility, but also the system will calculate for the functional test, like could be the mucus penetration test, or will take into account the number of round cells detected in these different fields. Okay? So once all these parameters are calculated, we can just close the analysis and save all the results in the database. We will save it, and automatically this information will be linked to this patient information, to this macroscopic information that we have introduced. It is recommended just to do the analysis of motility one by one because there is an evaporation of the chambers with the past of time, okay? So it's more accurate just to do the analysis one by one. Once the analysis is finished, we need to check if it's required to do vitality or not, okay? Just remember, according to WHO, when there is a poor motility, when there are less than 40% of motile cells, we need to test for vitality. For testing vitality, we will use a specific kit, okay, in which we will use a coloration, a reagent that is similar to the eosin-nigrosin solution that we will mix with our semen sample We will incubate it in order to allow a complete penetration of the eosin through these damaged cells. And we will put one drop of this mixture to a slide. And we will put immediately a second slide on the top of the first one. And then separate fully horizontal both slides. In this way, we can obtain two slides that you can use as a replicate. Okay, so this is the type of slides that are provided in the kit. Okay, and this is how slides should look like, okay, after doing the smear. Okay, so on the same way than before, we will just select for our vitality. We will select the same patient, the same reference, and we will introduce our sample, our preparation in the SCA scope and start the analysis. Just note that this sample it can be performed by serial ways, okay? You can just collect several samples and do it at the same time. So you can also analyze it on a serial way, okay? You can analyze four slides at the same time, because once you are doing the smear, this sample is fixed. It's not changing with the past of time, okay? It's not like in motility concentration that these sperm parameters are varying depending of the time that has passed, okay? Similarly than before, the system will show you a small preview to control what is happening inside the SCA scope, and immediately all the results appears. Here we are counting 200 sperms. Okay, so you can see that in just a few seconds, the system can calculate so fast. We can open that sessions and check that everything is going okay. If not, you can just modify manually if required. Okay, and then just close and save the analysis. And this information will be stored automatically in the database. Okay, so at the same time that we are evaluating if it's required to do the vitality or not, also it's important to take into account if it's necessary to do a peroxidase test or not. Okay, so when in the motility concentration test it is registered more than 1 million of round cells per milliliter, the system advises you to do a peroxidase test, to do an evaluation for the leukocytes, okay? To do that test, what we will do is just a specific preparation, okay, in which we will create a main substrate that we will use for first creating a positive and a negative control, okay? Once this substrate is mixed with water, with the ionized water, we will create a negative control in which we will not observe any change in the coloration of the reagent. Conversely, when we mix this substrate with a substance that is rich in peroxidase, it will involve enzymatic activity and therefore will trigger a change in the coloration of the solution. This will be our positive control to verify that the chemical reaction is occurring as expected. Okay? So once the negative and the control and the positive controls are checked, we can just mix this substrate with our semen sample and then take two small drops and put it on an analysis area. Here in the kit, you will see that there are included some slides that have three analysis areas, okay? And you can just choose one and load it, okay, in order to analyze it. So we will just select for our patient, okay, our reference. We will introduce the area that we want to analyze, for instance, area one. And then we will just locate the sample to the holder of the SCA scope and start the analysis. Here the system will capture 100 fields and will classify all these type of cells captured. It is important to know that the system has been trained to recognize not only the clear positive peroxidase cells, but also to detect these partially positive cells. This is very important because there are so many patients in which the profile of the peroxidase activity is just not so clear, okay? So you will find a lot of partial peroxidase cells. In that case, the system will assume it as positive, okay? Here, in just few seconds, the system will capture all these 100 fields, and we will be open just to see the sessions. Okay, you can see the fields captured. For instance, this is a partially positive cell that is clear brown, a clear positive cell that is dark brown, and all these negative cells that are fully translucent, so they are count as negative. So the system will take into account how many peroxidase positive cells there are in the ejaculate. When there is more than 1 million, it is assumed as an infection, and the sample should be immediately sent to the bacteriological laboratory. Okay? We will save the analysis. Okay? And then we can just continue with a morphology analysis. Okay? It is important to take in mind that both motility, vitality, and peroxidase activity are very sensitive to the past of time. Okay? So these three parameters should be assessed as soon as possible. Morphology is not very sensitive to the past of time, so we can just wait for later for doing this sample preparation. Okay? So for doing morphology, we recommend just to do a simple sperm washing, just to remove the seminal plasma from the ejaculate and resuspend these cells with PBS, with a saline buffer, in order to remove all these debris, all these noisy backgrounds that will be related to the seminal plasma. Okay, so just a simple centrifugation will allow to just remove this plasma and then clean all the samples with just PBS. Once our sample is washed, we can just continue with the smear, with the smearing that sample. We will use pristained slides, okay? That will allow the fixation and the staining of the cells in just one step, just doing the smear. And then we will just mount it with Elkit and a cover slip. Here there is one example of a pristained slide. Okay, this is how it looks like. And after being prepared and mounted, okay, we will put it here in the SCA scope. And yes, we will select morphology, the same patient, and we will run the morphological analysis. Okay. There are two ways to do the morphology analysis. You can do this analysis on a fast way, on express mode, in which the system will analyze at the same time all the fields that are captured, all the sperms that are captured on the same field, okay? But also there is the problem that when there are so many sperms on the same field, the tails tend to be out of that field, so it's impossible to analyze them. This is why it is also a possibility to do a specific analysis on a detailed mode, in which the system will select each sperm, will center in the center of the capture, and will analyze all the structures, including the tail. Okay, so there will be an automatic detection of the tail. So there are these two ways to do the analysis. Okay, and also it's very important. These are samples that can be perform it on a serial way. So you can also analyze, you can fill the four holders and do four serial analysis for morphology. Okay, this is a nice way to optimize your time. Okay, in just a few minutes, You can just get the main result for the morphology and also open that session. Okay, you can just open and check how the analysis has gone, how many abnormal cells there are, how many normal, how is the detection. You can also introduce manual corrections if you want. You can see all the details, all the abnormalities for each sperm cell. Okay, and you can just collect the main results for this sample, not only referring to the percentage of normal, abnormal cells, but also on the frequency on each type of abnormality. Once we are closing this analysis, we can just save the results in our database, okay, and continue with other analysis, like could be the DNA fragmentation. On the DNA fragmentation, we will follow the SCD test, the sperm chromatin dispersion test, in which we will encapsulate our cells in an agarose matrix, and then we will just incubate that, sperm cells in different solutions, in a denaturing solution and then analysis solutions, in order to trigger the reaction of the sperms to explode and spread all this DNA content all over the sperm head, okay? So the normal sperms are very sensitive to this treatment, to this incubation, to these different solutions, and will display a big halo surrounding the heads. Conversely, the damaged sperm cells are not sensitive to this treatment, and therefore will remain compact, will not show halos, and this will be the criteria that the system will use for classifying how many and quantifying how many fragmented and unfragmented cells that are in our preparation. Okay. Similarly, then with other tests, we will use some type of slides with two areas to be analyzed, okay? And we will just introduce the analysis that you want to do, the patient information, which is the area that you want to analyze, the first or the second, okay? Introduce the slide and run the analysis. So the system will go to that area, will screen and will count 100 or 200 sperm cells, okay? You can just customize the number of cells to take into account, okay? So you will have a total control of the system. You will see here what is happening inside the SCA scope, okay? And in that case, the system has captured 100 sperms in just a few seconds. We can just open and check the results. Also, it's possible to introduce some manual modifications if required, okay? Once everything is verified, you can just close and save the analysis. Okay, so for all these laboratories that are not only doing this conventional analysis, that also are doing treatments of the sample, it is important to know that the SCA scope also helps you to analyze post-treated samples and to evaluate the percentage of hyperactive sperms in this sample. Okay? To do that, we will use these counting chambers. We can use two types of counting chambers. There are chambers with a depth of 20 microns. This is important because we are using normally chambers of 10 microns depth for evaluating fresh semen samples. But when the sperms are treated and are activated, need more space for swimming freely. Therefore, we will need to use a deeper chamber, in that case a 20 microns chamber. If you want to follow WHO rules and therefore doing replicates for each sample. You can use these counting chambers with two chambers, okay? But also it is possible to select another type of chambers that allows to load six different patients, okay, for each slide. In that case, this is an example of a two chambers, okay? We will load on the same way. We will first put it on the first chamber, second chamber. We will dry the excess of liquid just to stop the drifting inside the chamber and analyze it, okay? So we will just select the motility module and we will check how many samples do you need to analyze a post-treated, okay? So we will select the sample, okay? We will introduce the slide and we will run the analysis, okay? So here is important just to control how many hyperactive cells there are, okay? We are assuming as a normal sample this that contains close to 20% of hyperactive cells, okay? So this could be a reference value for classifying if a sample is normal or not, okay? So here the system on the same way will capture 500 sperms on the first chamber, 500 sperms on the second chamber, and then we'll calculate the average between both. Also, we'll calculate the homogeneity within fields, okay? Just remember that you can just customize the option to delete automatically these fields that are very different from the average, from the rest, okay? And in just few seconds, you can obtain a complete analysis in which it is calculated the sperm concentration from my post-treated and how many sperms there are hyperactivated. This information will be automatically saved altogether with the rest of analysis and will be linked to that patient and to all the macroscopic information that we have introduced at the very beginning. Okay. So once all the analysis have finished, there is the possibility to validate that samples, okay? Here you can just look for the sample, have a look to all the results, okay? But normally there is the responsible of the laboratory or the doctor who needs to validate that results are accurate and are consistent, okay? So it's important to know that this person can validate these results directly from the system, but also can validate from a different places. When you connect that system to different databases or other computers, these doctors, these responsibles, can validate from their office or from a different building. Okay, so this is the importance of that system because it's not only optimizing the time, also is allowing just the transmission of the information to different places in a very easy way. Okay, so once the analysis is validated, you can just extract a report. This report can be fully customized, okay? We can just incorporate the logo of your laboratory, we can include images, all the information that you think that will be necessary for getting a good interpretation of the analysis, okay? And also, you can just send directly by email this report directly to the patient, okay? So the system could automatically transfer that information to the patient and also transfer all this information to the main laboratory system in order to upload everything, all the information for that patient all together. Okay? So once you are connecting that system, you can connect it to different computers, to different databases, or also you can connect to another SCAs, to another CASA systems, okay? Or to an editor, to a viewer complementary system. in order just to review, to open, to check, to validate all these analyses, all these captures that has been performed on the main laboratory with the SCA scope. So for instance, you can just, from any system, you can just select one analysis and open that session. You can open, you can see all the fields, you can see everything. You can maintain all the traceability for that analysis, okay? You can just introduce some modification or just to validate, get reports, okay? It's not necessary to work always on the main laboratory. Once you connect that system to another peripheral systems, you can just work from everywhere. So just to finish, I would like to just to refresh some time comparison between the manual methods and this automatic analysis with the SCA scope. Okay? It is important to take in mind that with the SCA scope, we are not only optimizing the time invested on doing one analysis, for instance. The time that a technician is investing in the microscope just counting and scoring the different samples, okay? So this technician can invest close to 50 minutes in just doing a full complete analysis for one sample. Meanwhile, by using the SCA scope, you can do the same screening in 16 minutes. But with the advantage that during this time, it is not required the presence of a technician. So meanwhile, this technician can be doing a different test or preparing other type of samples, okay? So at the end of the day, in which we have received so many samples, okay, we can realize that after analyzing 10 samples by using manual methods, we will have spent close to 10 hours for completing all the analysis. Meanwhile, the same analysis are performing just 3 hours by using the SCA scope, okay? So here is important to take in mind all the time that you are winning with that system, and also the standardization of the results, because the system is analyzing always on the same way, okay? So it's important just to take in mind. So thank you very much for your patience, and now is your time. You can ask your questions, okay? And thanks for all.